Congratulations. You are about to witness the world's first functioning time machine. Or not. Keep watching to find out. Sorry, I've been watching all these videos about gaming the YouTube algorithm. Step one is to start with a big, intriguing premise. Step two is to deliver. That part's gonna be a bit more tricky. I've always wanted to go to Burning Man. Giant art installations, music, dusty naked people everywhere. Yeah, but it's kind of a lot of work, so I thought I'd start by making my own little Burning Man. A burning baby. No, wait. Anyways, I've got these little Tesla coils, and they are some of the coolest gadgets I've ever owned. Just kidding. It actually takes a while before that gets painful. If this were a science channel, I'd explain how these are fairly safe despite high voltages because of low current and electrical resistance. No. Instead, I'm gonna build my magical baby Burning Man audio-visual electrical instrument slash light show slash time machine, maybe. These Tesla coils can do some really cool things, like wirelessly light up light bulbs, and even play music over Bluetooth. So they're definitely gonna be a big part of my creation, and I've also got this massive portable battery station by Yashapo that I'm gonna use to power the whole thing. It's got a whopping 2300 watt hour capacity, and that should be enough for some minor time travel. Anyways, we're gonna start by messing around with old electronics and fire. Yep, we're going all over the place with this video. My first order of business was to dismantle this broken television I picked up off of Craigslist, because inside of these old LCD televisions, we've got these bad boys. Cold cathode fluorescent lamps. I was super curious to see if my Tesla coils could get these to light up. And they totally do. They glow super bright, and they're even, like, touch reactive. How freaking cool is that? Now, eventually, I did research these bulbs a bit more, and I learned that the reason they light up is because the Tesla coil is exciting trace amounts of mercury vapor trapped inside, which interacts with a phosphor coating. So, sadly, as with most awesome things, working with these can be quite hazardous and bad for your health. Maybe that explains why I've been acting so strange in recent videos. Still, I was super excited by this discovery, so I quickly picked up a second flat screen TV, and I was devastated to find all those glorious CCFLs replaced by a few cruddy LED bulbs. I mean, it's impressive that a handful of LEDs could replace the older technology, but disappointing in this case. Well, at least I could use the diffusers inside that TV to enhance my shop lights. Anyways, despite limited light bulbs, I had another crazy idea of bending the rods using a propane torch. So with my HEPA filter and vapor grade respirator equipped, I fired things up. To my surprise, the glass melted super quickly. More surprising still is that they continued to light up with the Tesla coil. With a bit of practice, I was able to bend the bulbs without breaking them, and at this point, I felt like an absolute wizard. After bending and melting several pieces, I ran some tests to see how these held up. It was at about this point that I felt like I could probably warp through space-time at any moment. Pretty crazy, right? I'm not used to all my ideas just working like that, let alone better than I expected. That said, not everything worked out perfectly. If I zapped these metal ends for too long, the bulbs would end up failing. So I decided to melt those off using the torch as well. It's super fun, so I didn't have too much of a problem with that. But also, if the coil stayed in one spot for too long, it also failed. And I discovered that the Tesla coil was actually melting little tiny pinholes into the bulbs and presumably releasing all the toxic gases contained within. Lovely. So if I was gonna make some kind of lasting light installation, I knew I'd have to keep things moving to prevent everything from overheating. And that leads us to the next part of this creation. My Yoshapo power station came with this nice cart to aid with transportation, and I decided to use this pop-up handle to house my light show, along with some contraption that will move the Tesla coils up and down, lighting up all the different bulbs. I realized that I could use the screen from the TV I took apart earlier to make a nice backdrop for the lights, so I printed out some hangers using Filamentum's CPE filament, which I scored with a pointy tool so this VHB foam tape would stick onto it really well. Those hang onto the handle, and then I can add the screen. Nice. For the moving components, I'm gonna be using this old rotisserie motor. I love using these things because they provide a nice, slow, and controlled rotation. I printed some clips to connect the motor to these steel rods that I salvaged from an old 3D printer. And it seems sturdy, so I'll continue printing more hardware. This CPE filament can be a bit messy, but after cleaning it up with an X-Acto knife, it's totally usable. Here, I'm popping in some nuts, so this part will fasten to the rods, and then I can add that all to my setup. At this point, I realized I'm nearly out of CPE, so I switched to Matterhacker's Pro PLA for these next parts, which also connected to the steel rods. If you can't tell, I'm kind of winging this whole thing. These rods have threaded ends, which was awesome for connecting things together. And this part incorporates these slide bearings, which also came out of the same old 3D printer, so it's perfect for mounting my Tesla coils to these vertical rods, so they can move up and down. Now we just need to convert the circular motion of the rotisserie motor into this vertical motion for the coils. And for that, I used even more old printer parts and some other hardware I had laying around to make this special rotating arm. And before I get a bunch of comments about the shape of this thing, it's literally just the most efficient way I could combine these parts. Purely functional, okay? Anyways, it ended up twisting a lot, so I had to add this piece for support. And fine, okay, it looks like a Jeffrey Bezos rocket ship. There, I said it, let's move on. I connected that to the motor, and it spins. The final element to making things move is to add some pulleys, which, of course, I also printed, and I added some bearings so they'd be nice and smooth. And I added that to the ever-growing contraption. Unfortunately, I didn't get the angle quite right, so this paracord would slip off too easily. So I did have to design a second version of this part, and thankfully that seems to work better. So now I can connect the paracord from the Tesla coils over those pulleys and to the central arm. Huh, it's kind of working.
No way. It's struggling. It's creaking. Uh-oh.
The motor is really struggling to lift the coils, so I tried lubing up all the bearings and rods, and for a moment it seemed like it would do the trick. But the motor has this feature where it'll change direction if there's too much resistance, and that kept happening. By the way, how can this super lube include PTFE and still be food grade? I'm just curious. Anyways, the arm continued wagging, so I brought out another rotisserie motor to see if it's any stronger, and miraculously I was able to mount it to the same parts just by moving the clips around. so it seemed like the gods might be on my side. But this motor pretty much behaved in the same way. Still, the coils are getting a decent range of motion, so I decided to roll with it. So back to the light bulbs. I used a flexible TPU filament to print a bunch of these little struts that clip onto the bulbs, and those work pretty well. So I started arranging my light bulbs to try and figure out how to cover my backdrop, and then I used some more of that VHB tape to stick the struts and bulbs onto the screen. This was definitely some sensitive and precarious work, and I did end up snapping a few rods.
No.
But with my big show coming up, I had to make do with the few bulbs I had, and I think I still managed to make something pretty interesting. As for our music, well, I'm not much of an electrical engineer, but I can connect a bunch of things to other things. So I took my OP-1 synthesizer and used a cable splitter to separate the left and right stereo tracks, and then with some adapters, I could connect those to these cheap little Bluetooth transmitters. With that, I should be able to send separate signals to each Tesla coil. Oh yeah, stereo Teslas. All right, I think I'm ready for the performance of a lifetime. So let's disassemble the beast and head outdoors. My whole setup is contained and powered by this battery pack. Pretty cool. So, are you ready for the grand reveal? Silly question. Nobody's ready. I am so sorry about that. It's really hard to make these Tesla coils sound good. So how about I keep this voiceover going so you can at least see that the lights were sort of working. I mean, people do listen to Drake, so what do I know about music these days? Anyways, yeah, it was interesting. Some of the bulbs didn't want to light up even though they weren't broken, and it seemed like they were lighting up a bit more over time, like the gases inside were slowly charging up. I don't know. Clearly, this was all just a big experiment. You know, I spent a month making this silly thing, so it kind of is a time machine. Like, I wasted a lot of time. To be fair, there are a lot of different ways to define success. And maybe this failed to meet 99% of those definitions, but I had fun along the way and I got to experiment with some cool new tools and techniques. So at least there's that. Thanks to Yoshapo for sending me their battery for review. They probably expected something a little bit different. But I will say, this is actually super awesome. It can charge in 1.5 hours and run my concert for 17 hours, add a solar panel, and I could theoretically perform nonstop, night and day.
Where'd everybody go?
So, if you need backup power for your home, or you want to have the fanciest camping trip imaginable, check out the Yoshapo Y3000, link in the description. Thank you so much for joining me on this journey. Now do me a favor and leave a comment about how unbelievable it is that you just witnessed a real life time machine. So the next unsuspecting viewers will come along and stay for that performance. I love you guys. Stay awesome, stay curious, and as always, stay inspired. I mean, it's kind of cool. Kind of, sort of.